All right, guys, today's the day. We are gonna be doing something that, well, we're gonna find a unit, or rather we are going to be building a unit here that is going to defeat the Dark Peasant. Now, obviously the Dark Peasant can be defeated, well, not by main battle tanks, because he just deflects any incoming projectiles. I think you have to get melee attacks on him, but he can be defeated by the one and only Super Peasant. And so generally speaking, Mr. Super Peasant here is able to destroy him. That was a blue victory, and as I'll double check, blue was the Super Peasant. But before we do that, we're going to the secret faction, to the Ballooners, because apparently you guys saw the Ballooner do one of its new secret abilities, which is the meteorite ability. If I miss it, like, I need a timestamp. There's all these people like, Baron, I did it in the video. Just look. What? Hell, oh, there we go. Okay, so the Ballooner is turning into a meteorite, aka he's all on fire and falling to the ground. And when he hits the ground, it creates a bit of an explosion. So that's pretty cool. Okay, so actually a few of them did it. Yeah, in the last video, it was like, Baron, you missed this thing. If you guys throw in timestamps, whether you see like, oh, that was the funniest moment or something I missed, timestamp it in the comments, and that would be a huge help to me. But what I love about the comments is that if I do miss something, you guys let me know. So we're gonna be checking out some of the other secret unit updates that I missed. The teacher apparently has a new model. Is that so? Is it the sword that's different? I think the teacher had like more of a rapier, like a rapier. Smaller sword. Let's see how he does against two squires, because, you know, $200 versus 200. Let's see. He should be able to defeat them, right? He kind of reminds me of like Game of Thrones, the dancing teacher, which was basically the first sword of Braavos. So look at that. So red victory. Now let's see just how good he is against, let's go eight different swordsmen. Oh. Okay, well, that was a little unexpected. Now what if we run it again? Will he be defeated here? Okay, he blocked that. He's blocked that. He's dodging. He's blocking. He hasn't taken any of them out yet. Okay, there's one. So that was kind of funny. It seems to be a little bit of RNG going on right here, because here he's easily handling them, whereas the last one, he took one sword swing to the face and died. Now, I think he only killed three, because these guys are like, they look like they're just cuddling down there. Well, I don't want to fight, and it's cold out. Although that does look a little strange, doesn't it? And apparently the super boxer, the super boxer has a new ability, maybe? This was also pointed out in the comments, and I've been asking you guys, what custom faction should we make next? So leave that in the comments too. Okay, he kind of had a jump back. Ooh, he's definitely glowing right now, and he's coming in for a massive, like, slide punch. Oh, okay. I think we know what new ability the Super Peasant has. He kind of reminds me of the Shogun, how the Shogun runs in there. It's kind of like an old samurai movie where, like, it's the slow motion, everything stops, and then all of a sudden everyone realizes that they've been cleaved in two by the katana. Okay, so the Super Boxer, well, I'm actually kind of curious. Do you think a few Super Boxers here could handle and melee? Oh, that one got slapped and pushed aside. Okay, we're gonna need clearly a little bit more Super Boxers. How about that? Is that better? Will one of them get in there? They need to do the special ability where they, like, do the leaping thing, right? Come on, guys, leap! Oh, you're getting distracted by the hands. Wow. Yeah, we've got our hands full. We've got a difficult task here. Wow. Being able to throw... Is that new? Is the Dark Peasant grabbing someone and throwing him into someone else new? Look at this amount of money. We have $260,000. I guess these things are 10,000 and these guys are infinity. So maybe this is kind of fair. All right, let's see. I just need one of them to do that new super boxer ability to see if he can't get in there and punch him. Oh, they're getting in there. Oh, they were in there for a moment. Okay, so I feel like you need to make a unit that has a high mass so he can't be thrown around as easily. I wonder how high of a mass we can make a unit, like the heaviest unit. Okay, yeah, this is clearly not going well. Put a few chariots in here. I don't think they're gonna do anything, and I don't believe the chariots have any new unit or anything, but they should be. Wow. Every time they get close, he just does that explosive ability and everything dies. I mean, I wonder how much. Look at this guy. He's like not even affected by it. Okay, well, moving on to other secret abilities. So one of the other ones that apparently has a new ability was the Samurai Giant. So let's see him fight, well, a bunch of regular samurais. All right, so what's your new ability? Hopefully it's walking around the giant hole in the middle of the map. Now he swings and normally he does his flip. Oh, when he lands, he has a little bit of an area of effect there. It slams the ground and it pushes units away and even kills them too. So that's pretty impressive. Oh, that was pretty cool. Okay. Now, what if we put some warrior monks here too? You think we'll be able to defeat him? I mean, he's pretty good crowd control unit. So long as he doesn't fall in the hole! Jump out! Oh, okay. Well, you know, there he goes. And then apparently, he's the secret unit. The cheerleader got a new model? Let's see that. Oh, yeah. I guess they're wearing, like, headbands and they're wearing, like, some tie-dye shirts. So that's kind of funny. They got the long striped socks. Okay. And then one of the other ones was apparently Artemis, who is no longer the top secret unit, has a special ability that she'll use, but only if a unit gets in close. So I'm thinking in order to get in close, we're going to need some cavalry here. That should work. One of these guys is going to get in close. So firing the arrows, absolutely taking them down. I think her fire rate is a little bit slower. Whoa, 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 whoa. Oh my gosh. Okay, so she's creating a whirlpool? Or a tornado? What are you doing? I don't know what that did. Maybe we made her enemies a little bit too powerful. So let's have painters rush her instead. Oh, and painters can dodge. Okay, so... Oh! She creates like a giant powerful blast. So it's only if someone gets close, which is actually, I think, a little bit counterintuitive because you're powering up, which takes a little more time to fire when units are getting very close. But I guess it does a very good job at crowd control, so there's that too. So Artemis's new ability is pretty amazing. And then one of the other ones was actually in the Dynasty faction. The Monkey King has a new ability. So before, the Monkey King could teleport as well as clone himself or create visions or distractions, right? So what else can you do now? There's the cloning. And three different entities, which is pretty standard. Okay, now we've got four. I don't see... Am I missing? I could very well be missing something. Maybe being able to get, like, more than three? Oh, look at these guys. This is kind of funny when you clone yourself, but the other ones hold you back from fighting. Okay. Bam! Oh! Wait, is that new or is that not new? The ability to extend your rod. Because that seems kind of new to me. We need some more samurais here to see if that happens again. Yeah, being able to... There it is. Wow, dude, it looks like he's about to go pole vaulting. Okay, now he's only hitting a few people with it. It's stuck on that bush. I wish we could see it where it would do more, but the Reds actually were victorious. So why don't we try it on a big open field? Monkey King versus a ton of samurai. Because I want to see if he makes it bigger again, if he's able to swing it around everywhere and do a little bit of crowd control. Kind of. Okay, but see, that's kind of cool. So in the first one, we saw him cloning himself a lot more times. This one, he's using that. I don't know what dictates the use of one or the other, see? It's the RNG of tabs, which is kind of the beauty of it, being able to replay the same battle over and over and seeing different results. Like, if it was a classic health bar-based game, instead of, like, you know, in physics-based animation as opposed to, like, static animations, you would see the same ending or within a very smaller degree of variability. Which is pretty cool about tabs. Well, I mean, that is most of the ones that were pointed out to me. So I want to get the Dark Peasant Jr. against the Dark Peasant here real quick. I think we may have done that. Because I want to get a lot of Vlads. Because Vlad the Lad, well, I mean, he's able to summon spikes. And that's like the old Dark Peasant. So we're just going to do mad amounts. But I'm pretty sure that the Dark Peasant just doesn't care about the sticks. Yeah, we've done this before where it's just a giant explosion. Like, look at that. That is amazing. So you can't hit the Dark Peasant with range stuff. Oh my god. Like, look at this. And yeah, so pulling the spikes up from the ground doesn't do anything. I wonder, what if we were to... And this is like, I'm trying to learn here. Tempted to try the Jarl because he creates this little ice barrier. Maybe that could... I mean, it's not like we have a problem, I guess, keeping the Dark Peasant contained. He stays in the middle. We don't need these little ice walls, do we? Nobody gets close. Huh. Yeah. Like, are they even getting any hits in? He's just using the glove. Okay. Well then, it's time. It's time to try it out. We're gonna make an absolutely new unit called the DP Killer. Now, let's see. Your weapons, I think special abilities is where things come into play. Now, I'm wondering if we have projectile block, if that blocks the hands. Right? Because these Dark Peasant hands are really the problem. Lightning projectile block? What is that? Hold on. Oh, okay, you're not. Oh! Wait a minute. You kind of went Emperor Palpatine there, and you did block some of them. You're actually still alive at 100 hit points, so that's pretty impressive. Wait, what happened? What happened to these guys? Wait, oh, they're here. They just dropped their guns. Got it. Okay, so lightning ability block isn't really gonna help us much, I don't think, with the Dark Peasant. I'm gonna go with Master Projectile block. Now we need something offensive. What about a Pharaoh kneel? If we can make the enemy kneel down and stop fighting for a moment, it's possible. And if we can freeze him with ice breath? Let's try that. We still have two more abilities. Super Boxer Punch could be helpful. And then let's give him, I'm thinking honestly, we'll give you hover ability because that's what all superpowers have so far. Like the Dark Peasant, I'm pretty sure hovers. We'll make you like the God of Gods. I like this one a lot. Now, can I do another one? I think I can. This is fun. All right, you need an amazing hat. Look at that. All right, now as far as your shirt, we need to make you look kind of imposing, but if you're gonna be fighting the Dark Peasant, you're gonna have to be like a force of good. You know what I mean? Ottoman shirt. That's kind of cool. This is kind of cool. Whoa, a winged hussar. Oh man, all the Polish people gotta be super happy about that. So in the Tab G uniforms, this is kind of funny. Wearing a diaper. How about a doctor? Ooh, a mummy. Yeah, you're gonna be the mummy king, okay? Mummy king, decided. Now here's where the important part comes in. I think we need like 10,000 hit points. Your size and your unit weight needs to be like 100,000. Can you even do that? Oh my God, you can. And attack speed or damage, let's do it 1,000 attack speed. Oh, you know what? We should add a weapon though, right here. Okay, what weapons? Whoa. Thor's hammer. This is kind of cool. It shows you ranged or not. I'm thinking, oh man, adding in bazookas would be hilarious. Super peasant punch. I mean, we kind of need that. Throw with the Dark Peasant. That's a chakram? You can throw this? I think Thor's hammer is the way to go. And let's test it. Oh God. Oh my God. Oh my gosh. Okay. The special abilities are going crazy. Oh, there's a few Artemises out there. That's probably why. Let's just save this unit and we'll have them fight the Dark Peasant. Well, I mean, this is kind of the moment of truth. If this unit can do it. All right, 1 versus 1. Oh, wow. Okay, so this is actually interesting. Tabs, if you look in the lower right, has estimated this to be $8 million worth of units. Okay, we've already made contact. Wow. With the Dark Peasant here. Who won? Red Victory? Red Victory was the Dark Peasant. Dang it. We were close. Oh, Red Victory again. Maybe we weren't that close. Okay, let's try two of them. I can't tell if the Pharaohs is really working. Wait, hold on. I have to see through the ice breath here. I think we need to take off ice breath to see if the Pharaoh's working. Okay, one hand just slapped him. Oh, blue victory. We've done it. Wait, it only cost us 16 million. Wow. Okay. Now the moment of truth then. What about if we throw in the super peasant too? I don't think this is going to work very well. Okay, that was a red victory, I think, by a landslide. Let's put 3, 4. So that's what, 32 something million, maybe 33 million when it rounds up here. I think the Pharaoh does help because it freezes the enemy unit. The Dark Peasant, red victory again. What are you doing? Is the Dark Peasant dead? I can't see his eyes. They're covered by the... Yes! Okay, we destroyed the Dark Peasant. Now it's we just don't know how to kill the Super Peasant. Wait, hold on. How much money was that? 411 million. 41 million? I think. I don't know how numbers work right now. I'm just so excited. Look at this. Okay. Whoa. The Super Peasant got knocked into the ground. Where? Oh. He comes out to destroy him. Okay. Well, we did do it. And it took us 2. So we couldn't win a 1-on-1 fight, but we could win a 2-on-1 fight. And Ice Breath and Pharaoh helps freeze him. And then look at that, coming in for the final hit. Blue victory defeated the red team. Voila. Oh my God. We had a spider dark peasant to end it off.
Oh, that's great. All right, guys. Well, thank you for watching another episode of Totally Accurate Battle Simulator. Pull the trigger on the like button if you did enjoy the video. And the key things are, one, what custom faction should we make in the next one? And did I miss any other units that got the secret unit ability update? So thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.